Thank you so much. I'm incredibly humbled and grateful. There have been so many great athletes to come through Messiah, and it means a lot to be able to represent the women's basketball team in the Hall of Honor. I want to share a quick story with you. I'm married to my husband Reed, and we have 4 kids. My basketball playing days seem like a lifetime ago as I'm busy raising my little ones. This year, all 4 are playing basketball, and it's been fun to play with them around the house and show off my skills a little bit. The other day, we introduced the classic movie Space Jam to the kids. In the movie, the monsters steal the basketball talent from the NBA players, so they're no longer able to dribble or shoot or anything. After watching the movie, one of my little ones looks at me and says, "Mommy, did the monster steal your talent too?" Kids always know how to keep us humble. I told him that yes, the monsters did steal my talent, and the kids' monsters' names are Colin, Joel, Greenie, and Chris. If it wasn't for 4 crazy kids, I might still be able to dribble and shoot. But in all seriousness, I would like to thank my family, especially my parents, for all that they did to make sure I had every opportunity possible to develop my gifts and abilities. You made a lot of sacrifices through the years, and I would not have experienced the success I did without your support. You taught me the importance of a strong work ethic, instilled in me a love for competition, and encouraged me to believe big. I would also like to thank my sisters. You were my first competitors and my first teammates growing up as we played every sport imaginable together. You have both been so supportive of me. You were both incredible athletes yourselves, and in situations where we could have been competitive with one another, we always chose to love and support one another instead. I'm so grateful for that love and support. Ashley transferring to Messiah the year before me to play field hockey was a big reason why I decided to transfer here. And playing against Shelley, who played for LVC during my senior year, was memorable to say the least. She guarded me during those games, and let's just say she was pretty effective. I would also like to thank my husband, Reed. We met after the season my sophomore year, and I love that you got to know me outside of basketball first. However, once the season started junior year, you became my number one fan and you haven't stopped since. You still love to embarrass me by telling new friends about my playing days. I would also like to thank the coaching staff. Coach Miller, Norma, Coach Noble, Coach Sassman, and Coach McAllis, you're the best at what you do. Your care and commitment for your players, both on and off the court, means so much. I speak from firsthand experience to say that your influence has shaped my life and pointed me towards Christ time and time again. I value my relationships with each of you, and I'm so thankful for your ongoing role in my life. I'd also like to thank Wendy Chesman, who I spent a lot of time with in the training room. She also truly cared about me as a person and was always so patient with me as we tried to figure out what was wrong with my knees. If it wasn't for Wendy, I don't think that I would have been able to finish out my career playing basketball. I'd like to also thank my teammates who I played with at Messiah. I'm biased, but I think I had the best teammates. They challenged me and taught me so much. I have so many great memories from my time at Messiah and all are with my teammates. We just had so much fun pranking each other, choreographing songs and dances, and visiting some of the coolest places together. Like Steve said, I transferred to Messiah after my freshman year. I had accomplished my goal of earning a starting spot at a Division I school, but I was miserable. Spiritually, I was broken. Physically, I was in bad shape as well. I was hurt that entire year and did not get the problem addressed until after the season, so I was in a lot of pain. I ultimately decided that when I looked back on my college days, I wanted to know that I had experienced growth in all areas of my life, not just in athletics. I decided to come to Messiah, but I was not convinced I was even going to play. My doctor had told me to quit basketball and play field hockey instead because it would be easier on my knees. I decided to meet with Coach Miller and Coach Noble before coming to be polite. In that meeting, they described the program to me. They talked about how it's more than just basketball, it's about glorifying God through our talents and using our platform to share Jesus with others. They talked about how close-knit the team was and how school, family, and faith are important to them. They talked about service projects and regular devotional times together. They talked about how they teach their players how to play the game of basketball, not just how to run a set of a bunch of plays. I left that meeting knowing I had to play for this team and these coaches. My time at Messiah was filled with a lot of growth, and I knew that this is where God wanted me to be for this time in my life. While I knew this is where I should be, it was not without some frustration and setbacks. I had surgery on one of my knees the spring before coming. That surgery helped the pain, but never fully resolved it. Then during my first scrimmage at Messiah, I hurt my other knee and ended up having surgery on that one over Christmas break. My father was also diagnosed with cancer around this time as well, and began treatment. There were days when I wasn't sure if I should stop playing so that I could relieve the pain and be able to spend more time with my family, as my dad underwent chemo. I ultimately knew that this was right where God wanted me to be, and he wanted me to press on and do my best to glorify him through it all. I learned a lot about perseverance during those years at Messiah. I learned that just because it's hard doesn't mean you aren't following God's calling. I learned the importance of pushing through the difficult times in faith, knowing that God will honor that hard work and perseverance. For me, that was the thrill of playing in the national championship game my senior year. These lessons I learned at Messiah have never been more relevant to me than in the last 2 years of my life. 2 years ago, my husband and I became foster parents and journeyed into a world of brokenness, uncertainty, and parenting traumatized children. It has been rewarding, challenging, and refining. Our youngest two came to us as foster children, and their adoption will hopefully be finalized in the next few months. There have been many times over the past 2 years where I've persevered through hard days and sleepless nights. The thought of giving up and going back to my more comfortable life has crossed my mind more times than I care to admit. However, each time I come back to the clear call that God has on my life, and I'm reminded of all the ways he's been faithful to our family in these past 2 years. When God calls us to something, that does not mean it's going to be easy, but he promises to walk with us every step of the way. He has been faithful, and we are so thankful to be where we are now. We have the privilege of parenting these two incredible children who we now can't imagine our life without. We are so close to the thrill of officially welcoming our two kids into our family forever, and I'm so thankful that I learned the value of perseverance years ago while at Messiah. Thank you.
Nikki's speech was hard to follow, but I should go first. It's truly an honor to be part of this amazing group of athletes and coaches. Congratulations again to Nikki, Cynthia, and Neil tonight. Tonight is a reminder of all the people and experiences that have helped shape who I am today. I'm very fortunate to have great parents help push me and support me. I was also lucky to have many great coaches and teammates throughout my career. Also, big thanks to my wife, who was in middle school when I went into college, so she was unable to be a distraction. When you fall off or whatever, your partner records the distance. that recorded distance would be on a wall in the locker room the next day in order for everyone to see. So your partner was there encouraging you and also catching you as you wiped out. But, sorry, I can type this. So that was 8 months before our next season started. So it was far more mental preparation than physical training for the following season. We took that mental strength into the following year, and the NCAA tournament my junior year, we outscored our opponents 17-0. We went on to win a third national championship for the Maasai men's program. It's hard to get to the top, and even harder to stay there. In 2005, my senior year, we went undefeated and untied, winning the fourth national championship for the men's team, and finishing the season a perfect 24-0. Coach Brand and the rest of the coaching staff continued to do an amazing job to keep us sharp and focused. The foundation for this dynasty was built long before I arrived at Maasai. On the backs of the players and coaches that came before me, I was very fortunate to be able to be part of a system and win multiple national championships. I'm proud but not surprised to see that the dynasty continues under Coach McCarty and the rest of the current coaching staff. The relationships and friendships that were built during my time at Maasai mean the most to me. I've had 6 knee surgeries post-college, 3 ACL tears. I'm scared if I get near a soccer ball, I'll have another one. But the friendships and the relationships I've made with the people of my time here, they'll live on forever. Thank you.
Presence was an encouragement to us. So that each time that we scored a goal, we defended a corner, won a playoff game, I understood that, being the body of Christ, we were one for a cause. We cheered all for him, not because we thought up such a great cheer on our own, but because it was what Messiah Field Hockey was about, long before my time and remains so today, under the coaching of Brooke Good, whom I actually want to also say a special thanks for tonight. And it wasn't just on the field. Part of my work as a professor today is to study other cultures and societies, which for me first came with the essential intermixing of liberal arts and athletics here at Messiah. I vividly recall a cold fall morning in 1993, shortly after we lost in a playoff bid. That morning I received news that I was named Rookie of the Year, and I found myself sitting in the front row of an 8 a.m. Japanese cultures class in Frye Hall. Our professor asked us to consider the social and economic structures in Japan, and to take time to consider that factory workers make less than those in the offices above the factory floor, despite the incredible efforts and long hours that those workers put in. And I remember in that moment, with a taste of both personal victory and collective defeat playing a paradox in my mind, a clear sense of the collective good to everyone, and that success at any level came as the result of strengths of many individuals joined together and united under one mission. Later, my husband and I, while living in Uganda, came upon the concept of Ubuntu in Swahili. I am because we are. That would often remind me of the days of victory and defeat on the field, and the learning that catalyzed here, and that so many of the privileges that we enjoy in sport today have been given to us by the generations before us. That the roots of our tree, that those who have given life to the branches and fruit that I just mentioned, are part of an ongoing legacy that is so appropriate to recall here tonight. The day before I departed California to come here, I was teaching a sociology of sport class on Title IX and gender. There are women here, sitting in this room, who didn't learn those lessons from texts, like I did, like many others here in this room do, but they lived it. They can recall a time when it was merely a dream to have a woman welcomed into a hall of honor alongside men, like tonight. When sports and coaches for women were not a serious endeavor. I was raised by just such a woman, Deborah Jean King Toms. I say her name that way because I recently recognized how similar that name is to Billie Jean King, and if you know my mom, you'll know she dominates on the tennis courts. And even today has been known to be the best of athletes, my husband included. A run for his money. And she herself was recently awarded her own honor among Delaware Women Sports Hall of Fame. My mom was my first and lifelong coach. And I don't just say that in some metaphoric, figurative way. I mean that in a like whistle in hand, call out. I had to call her coach. I remember her saying, just keep running because Toms are tough. With mom as a coach, I did a lot of extra laps, dribbling with my left hand around and around the field. When we were done practices, mom would make me do extra things just to keep me out of her hair while I cleaned up, knowing that someday I'd probably need that skill. And as I later became a head coach myself, she was always one phone call away with encouragement and tactics. Even starting my own coaching career, she gave me a book of devotions on team sports. And that was part of her legacy of faith in sports as she paved the way for so many women like me today. And it's not just the women that paved the way. My father, although a gifted athlete, will tell you he was never a huge sport enthusiast. He was, however, a big enthusiast for support. He never expected my mom to be in the kitchen or the house when she could be out playing tennis or field hockey. And finding creative ways to support our team efforts, he videotaped from a high reach, driving long distances to watch field hockey games that remain, as they do for many in this room, I'm sure, a total mystery because of all the whistles and etiquette. My parents always found ways to script and save so that I could attend camps and special clinics, and for that I'm eternally grateful, and I recognize this was part of the legacy that was given to me. It's no surprise then that I sought and married a man who also recently had his own Hall of Fame induction that I was able to witness years ago, and whose success as a professional triathlete still earns him the family title of "That's where those boys get that athletic ability from." Which rightfully so. He has always encouraged me to be more, to do the things that I love and felt most joy doing. And so as I stand here today reflecting on the legacy that I was born into and privileged to continue, I can't help but wonder, what chapter will I leave? What chapter will my teammates, who cried and cheered and won and lost with me, what will we leave here at Messiah?
Will we be able to come back in 20 or 40 years and be proud of the progress that our generation has made, to look on legacy with the same pride that the men and women here do today? What am I willing to fight for so that these halls of honor continue to represent a more full picture of the kingdom of God and his people? I have to question who's still not represented. Now that we women have made it through the door, who do we need to turn and hold it open for in the next chapter? To reach back with a hand and pull forward. Dare I say that our beloved sport of field hockey, if it is to remain thriving, must also evolve to remain relevant. Perhaps we're called to think beyond a sport that's primarily mid-Atlantic, upper middle class, and maybe think about a legacy, and perhaps learn something from the opening of golf to so many diverse kids, a new generation of talent that draws from a large pool, again representing the kingdom of God. Although this isn't just a call for Messiah or for field hockey as an enterprise, because structures change slowly, we're asking this at my own institution as a way to kind of think about our own locale. But we do have a field and we do have influence to continue to see that potential groups are represented. 60% of new church growth in America is immigrant communities. Perhaps we have a whole new crop of new recruits, and one that also, again, represents the greater body of Christ that will one day stand and see their faces honored here. So as we sit in this hall, surrounded by a campus that has changed a myriad of ways since my time here, and will continue to change for years to come, I find myself grateful to be a part of a moment in our history. So incredibly humbled and grateful to be a part of Messiah's team history and our successes, failures, and joy. And I'm also grateful for the deep influences in my life, the ones represented in this room, as well as the broader body of believers that welcome this legacy and ultimately not just the team, but more largely reflected God, whom as a team and this institution continue to serve and make known. All for him.
Wasn't in God's, again, providence at that point in time. And I went back to my hometown in Clearfield, and Jim Gustafson became the wrestling coach. And I was in Clearfield 6 years, and then I was in Lock Haven 11 years. And in 1991, Emerson Fry, and I'd like to thank President Hostetter, Leighton Shoemaker, and Jim Gustafson, I became the Messiah College wrestling coach. And it just continued to help me to deepen my walk with the Lord and to help to understand God's purpose for your coaching. I'm actually just a farmer's son who majored in physical education and specialized in wrestling. I'm just an athletic educator. I did my first coaching in the fall of 1961. And tomorrow, 40-some of the boys I work with will be wrestling in a youth tournament. Four students in the junior high will be wrestling in a junior high tournament. And 12 of the varsity students will be wrestling in a section tournament. As coaching is what God has called me to do. He's given me the passion to do it, the desire to do it, and hopefully the ability. I wanted, with all the wrestlers, I kind of wanted to have practice when I got up there on the stage. That was my first thought. I said, warm up, guys, let's rock and roll. Here we go. Would all the wrestlers please stand? All the wrestlers, please stand.
Lord of your lives and every single thing that you do.
I am really excited about what God is doing in wrestling since Brian took over the leadership. No one would have, when I was outside the cafeteria recruiting students in 1991-92, just trying to fill all the weight classes, who would have ever thought that Messiah College in the 21st century would be one of the most powerful Division III programs in the United States. So thank you, Lord, for bringing Brian here. Thank you to the athletes who have responded to his leadership and are attending here. It's just so heartwarming for me to realize, from recruiting outside the cafeteria to seeing, you know, the accomplishments of the present men that are here. But the most important single person in all of this, Marcella, would you please stand up? If God had brought me together with any other woman born in this world, I would be living at the Holiday Inn and eating at McDonald's. Coached in all kinds of different situations, and I know of no one who would have traveled with me, supported me, and believed in me like Marcella Turner. And even and our sons, too, have everywhere we've been, they've been a part of what we're doing and help with that. That's why a lot of you may not realize, but when I left Messiah, I went back to Lock Haven, and for 11 years I did a club for Lock Haven University. But then I realized that our son was coaching over in Lancaster County in Conestoga Valley, and he needed someone to do for him exactly what I was doing in that club. So this is the fourth year we moved to Lancaster, Pennsylvania, and I'm assisting our son. I'm in charge of the youth program, assisting with the varsity. But wrestling is what I do. In other words, their season is spring, fall, winter, and summer. I have no season for what I do. But I make no one do it. I just always, always make it available to them. And I have children that I'm working with all the time. So I'd like to thank publicly Marcella, publicly our sons, and also all the people that are here that were friends with me when I was here. And Jack's right. I graduated from Penn State with a degree in physical education. But if you know me very well, I'm not a very gamey guy. You know, fun for me is getting up at 5 a.m., going to the fitness center in Conestoga Valley and working out for an hour, okay? That's fun, so I'm not a gamey kind of guy. So I wasn't crazy about teaching physical education and flag football and so forth. I think that's all good. My son's fantastic at that. But when I came here, they let me teach life fitness. I loved it. Because what you were doing is you were helping people to learn how to take care of their bodies. And we had lectures and stuff that went along with that regarding nutrition and psychological and so forth, and I loved that. And I really came to realize, yes, I am a physical educator, but I'm more of a fitness person than I am a gaming person, and so forth. And that's still true. Wrestlers always want to play a game or something before or after practice, and I always tell one of the assistants, would you take care of that? I don't like to keep score. So, now again, our son Trent, he's phenomenal with that, but that's not me, you know, that's not who I am. Psalm 127:1 was given to me by John Mitchell when I came here my first year. He was the heavyweight from Virginia. He's the athletic director of McCaskey High School now. He's been at McCaskey since he graduated from, he's been in the city schools of Lancaster since he graduated from Messiah College. He was a wrestling coach, now he's the athletic director, and he gave me this verse. Unless Psalm 127:1, in the context of this verse is actually about your family, but Messiah is a family. Unless the Lord builds a house, those who build it labor in vain. And I never forgot that, because that's 100% correct, and it's 100% true of every program here at the college. Everyone is attempting to build on a foundation that is Christ. Coaching is teaching. It's about giving yourself away. Jim Elliot, who was martyred, and all of you know Elizabeth Elliot, and Jim Elliot was her husband years and years ago, and he was martyred along with several of his friends. He made this statement, and I claim this. He is no fool who gives what he cannot keep to gain what he cannot lose. All of us have talents, gifts, treasures, possessions, and time. The greatest thing you can do is find somewhere where you can give that away to another person. Because when you pass into the presence of Christ, what you gave into the lives of others will stay with them. And hopefully, as 2 Timothy 2:2 says, the things that you have been taught, teach to trustworthy and faithful men that they may teach others. And that means human beings, Cindy. I'm not going to take Title IX back. It doesn't just mean men, it means human persons. Whatever you've been taught, teach to trustworthy and faithful men that they may teach others. We hear a lot of talk about not emphasizing winning. Based on the philosophy that Messiah College has, is, and will be utilizing, you can't emphasize winning too much. Because it's winning that is a process of developing people's lives spiritually, emotionally, mentally, and psychologically, that they go out and as unto the Lord, with Christ in their hearts, they give it all they have every time they get out there. Matter of fact, I say this a lot just to get people's attention. I'll say, Messiah never loses. Now you got everybody's attention. But sometimes they run out of time. So that's how you have to coach, and hopefully that's how the men and women who represent this marvelous, one-of-a-kind institutions will carry on, not just in athletics. Athletics is temporary. Life is, that's the real deal. So carry those things. Our one son made this statement. All three of our sons graduated with highest honors from Lock Haven University. But the second son made this statement. He said, I did not learn to be a good student in the classroom. I learned to be a good student in athletics. I just applied those lessons to the classroom. So everything you do, your role as a husband, your role as a father or mother, son or daughter, that type of thing. So I just pray that the beat goes on. I do believe with all my heart you have a president who's very excited about athletics, and that is a blessing. I think she really loves what's going on with the athletic department and the men and women that are coming through here. So I just stand with a humble, thankful heart. I thank you men so much for being here tonight. May God continue to bless you. May you continue to stay focused on Christ. Colossians 1:27, Christ in me, my hope of glory. So thank you for an unbelievable evening. I think the other inductees would be quick to agree with me. It's a lot easier to achieve than it is to receive recognition. God bless you all.